In this tutorial, I'll show you how to create a gradient material for hair particles. Let's select and hide the meshes. I'll show you how I have created two separate hair particle groups from a single mesh. The base mesh was a UV sphere. Tab to go to edit mode and deselect all. Use C to circle select like this and type P to separate. Let's separate one more group of meshes by holding Alt and Shift to select multiple edge loops like this. We won't need the original mesh. Let's add hair particles to the top mesh. I'll add the hair particles to the second mesh. Let's add one more UV sphere, subdivide it, and smooth it. I'll show you why I have used the separate method to detach multiple faces before applying two separate hair particle groups. Let's say we had another UV sphere, and we wanted to add hair like the one we've just created. We can use the hair trim and comb tool to edit the hair particles, but that will take too much time. We could also utilize the vertex group method to limit the number of faces to have the hair particles like this. Then if we wanted to keep another set of hairs on the same mesh, it would be difficult to arrange one. This is why I used the face separate method to create two separate hair groups in a single mesh. If the original mesh needs to be kept, then it would be better to duplicate the selected face first, before separating them. I'll show you how the gradient materials were created. I'll show you the full nodes. The second set of gradient material looks like this. The sphere in the middle had a metallic material. This is the end of the tutorial. Thank you for watching.